So I'm just going to hop right to the point here. It's come to my attention that some members of our community have been harassing the creators behind this year's Smismas update. And by the word harassing, I don't just mean leaving constructive criticism, I mean leaving some straight up, hate-filled comments on some of these creators' boards. Now, I'm not entirely sure where this all started. I mean, I know some content creators like Zesty Jesus clearly verbalized their dislike for this year's cosmetics, but even then, none of the content creators I watched then went and told their viewers to go bash those content workshop creators afterwards, so it really shouldn't have come to this. Now, it's no secret Valve obviously didn't pick the best lineup of cosmetics this year. I mean, like I've said before, part of the reason I usually never do Smismas unboxings anyway is because I generally just think they throw in some of the most generic, Christmas-related stuff they can think of year after year. I mean, after all, how many Santa hats or elf hats are we actually gonna use? And as far as the maps go this year, yeah, some of them clearly needed some work, the most notable entry obviously being Bread Space, but I'm gonna make the case to you all now why you really shouldn't be attacking the content creators here and should more so be upset at Valve. First off, I think it's important that Valve keeps some pretty loose rules on what items they allow to be posted in the workshop. TF2 is a 14-year-old game at this point, and without all these content creators' different inputs and ideas, it could be pretty difficult to keep this game's workshop interesting and valuable. Because of this though, you're gonna get a lot of good ideas, you're gonna get ideas that are similar, some that are literally the exact same thing, and some that are just downright terrible. Need I remind you, this exists. Or, for instance, the map Scout and Asylum, which is literally just a scout in a white padded room, and if you touch him, you insta-die. And this map is rated 5 stars, by the way. Anyways, if one of these creations were to make it into the game, it's not the creator's fault it got into the game, it's Valve's. It should be their responsibility to care not only about their game enough, but the community enough to put in good creations. In other words, it should be their responsibility to make sure they're putting in items people actually want, and not just duplicates or low-hanging fruit. And in my opinion, I think what actually upset people more so this year than the quality of the cosmetics was just the overall theme of the cosmetics. Valve really decided to double down this year with the Christmas-only theme, and really didn't give us any other type of cosmetic that could make sense to use year-round. I mean, for instance, the Mushanka was basically one of the only Smismas cosmetics we got this year that really seems like it could pass as a regular cosmetic. And again, this was Valve's fault. This year, they didn't even just pick their cosmetics from the most popular list in the workshop. They went out of their way to pick some of these items from the previous year's lineup, and even the year before that. Now, going back to the maps, this is again something I really think we shouldn't be blaming on the content creators themselves. A lot of the times, community map creators really try their best to make good maps that seem like they could fit into the game. But it's really not the content creator's fault when Valve doesn't give the content creator the right amount of testing to make sure their map will even work for the game. Take for instance last year's Whatville. Now, 13 was the creator of the map Whatville, and he hadn't touched that map in over 4 years, but it's been well documented at this point that Valve basically went up to 13 like days before the Smismas update and was like, "Hey, so we've got the Smismas update that we haven't been preparing for like at all, and we liked your random map from a few years ago, so if you could just go ahead and get that map completely casual ready in the next few days, that'd be great. Thanks." So, 13 basically had to try to go back and then fix up this map that he hadn't touched in years within a few days, and that clearly didn't pan out too well. And in response, the community bashed his map into oblivion. And this year's not looking too much different. Like I touched on in my last video, Bread Space clearly wasn't ready by the time Valve decided they wanted to put it in the game, and so we're dealing with some of the same consequences now. But most importantly, the thing I want to touch on is the reason I think it's really dumb to attack the content creators behind these creations is that without them, we'd pretty much have nothing left of TF2. Valve does not make their own TF2 updates anymore. In fact, probably the last time we saw anything original in TF2 put out by Valve was all the way back at the Jungle Inferno update. And even then, most of those maps and cosmetics were community created. Since then, we have continued to get these small cosmetic drops, Scream Fortress updates, and Smismas updates, and that's it. But all of that content is created by the community. If you chase away the community, if you bully them off of their platform and make them no longer want to make things for this game, that's likely going to be it for us. No more cool new maps, no new cosmetics, no new custom modes, no heavy weapon concepts, no nothing. The community workshop is absolutely what has been keeping this game alive, and this is just not the route we want to go. Imagine, for instance, if someone like UEAK Crash had been bullied off the platform, and we never got to see some of his creations like Shore Leave, Oasis, Probed, Monster Mash, and Glassworks. That's essentially what you could be doing by spewing these hate-filled comments at creators. So please just remember, there's a big difference between constructive criticism like, "Hey, maybe you could move this spawn point from last to mid, it would really help the map flow better," versus comments that are just completely unhelpful and hateful, like, "Wow, this is the worst thing I've ever seen, and it makes me want to die." So anyways, I hope you guys will just consider this. I hope that our community can be more considerate in the future, and that's the end of my rant. Until next time, this was Big Joey, Later.